I wasn't really aware that Jackie Chan Stuntmaster existed when the game first came out for the PlayStation 1. I was like 10 years old, which is also way too young to give a shit that the game was awarded an 8 out of 10 on an internet video gaming website. But now as an adult, I don't know. The idea kind of intrigues me. Is Jackie Chan really an 8 out of 10? Really? And what was an 8 out of 10 game like 15 years ago? Has it been able to withstand the test of time? I had to find out. Nope. Nope. Not even close. It is not a good game. It's like 6 hours long, and I would say I experienced everything it has to offer in the first 10 minutes. There's pretty much no story, and for a brawler beat-em-up, there's no co-op, there's no playing with friends, there is only Jackie Chan. Perhaps the only sellable feature about this entire game. Come on, it's Jackie Chan! That's all we got, it's Jackie Chan! So they made sure they got it right. They got a 3D facial scanner to make sure they can get the full Jackie experience in the game. But it's a PlayStation 1, so his face only has like 4 polygons. Seriously, what a waste of time. The motion capping they did with him is not at all what is actually in the game. There was a Jackie Chan year 2000 downgrade. Hey Jackie, who's the greatest video game character ever?
Me. Jackie.
Me, Jackie. I will hit you in the face if you disagree. All right? You wanna know what I think? I think everyone who reviewed Jackie Chan was afraid to give him less than an 8. Can you imagine giving Jackie Chan a 6? You're dead. You're probably dead. Every person he beats up in this game is pleading and begging for their life.
Watch it! Somebody call the cops! What did I ever do to you?
What did he do to you, Jackie? Why does he want to call the police because you're here? Criminals don't do that.
I don't want trouble! Ow! At last I meet the famous Jackie Chan!
He just wanted an autograph. He was a fan. No, he's not killing him, he's just knocking him unconscious.
Don't mess with me again!
And crushing their bones and cremating them.
I'm gonna puke!
Pretty happy about it. I'm gonna puke! Why is he so excited?
I'm 8 years old, my parents beat me every night, and the only way I can take vengeance out on the rest of humanity is to build shitty Super Mario Maker levels where you have to guess which door. And if you guess wrong, you die. Isn't that awful? Let's put that shit in Jackie Chan! What the fuck? Don't hit your kids. They grow up and develop this shit. Go try it again. Pick a different door. It doesn't even matter. This whole area doesn't matter. Because I don't think the developers ever expected you to actually get this far. It's locked off by an even more difficult train section that I can't imagine anyone in the world has ever actually beaten. They made this part as obnoxious as possible to hide the fact from you that the rest of the game is way worse. The rooftop level that comes after this is just the same level copy and pasted 3 times. It just gets worse and lazier, and you know what? Don't even worry about it. It would take a while to demonstrate. It doesn't matter, because from the beginning, this was my own personal search, and I found what I was looking for. I found out that an 8 out of 10 game 15 years ago is exactly the same as an 8 out of 10 game now. It's completely meaningless. In 2014, GameSpot's Game of the Year was Middle-Earth: Shadow of Mordor. They gave this game an 8. So, in conclusion, an 8 out of 10 game can be Game of the Year material. Perhaps it could be a graphical benchmark for an entire generation. It could be every Call of Duty game ever made and that will ever be made. Or it could simply just be Don Bradman's Cricket. Sure, yeah, why not? I mean, even Sniper Elite, I've already proven, was at the very least an 8. Truthfully, everything is an 8 out of 10. There's no exceptions. Here's an exception. Heroes of the Storm has a 6.5? Are you kidding me? This game has a cast full of well-known characters. You can't do that. It's an 8. It's an 8 every time. I know there's probably millions of people who play League and Dota that would totally agree with you that Heroes of the Storm is mediocre and not as good as the Supreme Bible games, but you can't say that. It has Blizzard characters in it, dude. Once people like something, you jump at the opportunity to agree with them. That's the only reason Five Nights at Freddy's has a review. Heroes of the Storm, getting a 6.5 from one person, was at the top of the news for the day on Reddit's r/games. Briefly. For a little bit. I mean, obviously it was immediately taken over by Witcher 3 circle jerking shortly after, but it was really big news to a lot of people. So, do you express a completely reasonable opinion, or do you offend nobody and keep your audience? I think the answer's obvious. Jackie Chan, 8 out of 10. I fucking love Jackie Chan. Guy's a god, legend. Well, I beat Jackie Chan. Guess I don't need this anymore. I don't know why I got all these.